Hey there, and welcome back to another episode of the Parkinson's Disease Education Podcast. If you've wondered about whether you should take your medications at certain times of the day based upon, let's say, when you're eating meals, or you've been wondering if you should be eating protein or how much protein you should be eating, those questions come up quite often. And if that's the case, this is the episode for you, because we're going to be talking about protein and levodopa absorption, as well as some tips for meal timing and some options on diet when it comes to protein absorption, or rather protein intake in your diet. You're gonna wanna stick around to the end of the video, because at the end I'm gonna share a couple of diets that are potential options for you as a person with Parkinson's disease when it comes to protein consumption. Now, those are diets that I'm not particularly familiar with other than the research I did for this episode. However, speaking to a registered licensed dietitian would be really beneficial, as well as to, if you can, find a registered licensed dietitian who specializes in neurodegenerative disorders. Good luck with that search, but they are out there. Without further ado and without further hesitation, we're going to get right into the introduction to the show. And on the other side, we'll talk about levodopa absorption and protein. Hit it. Welcome to the Parkinson's Disease Education Show, where we demystify the disease and empower you as the person with Parkinson's disease to reach your true potential. The content contained on this show is for informational purposes only and is not meant to be a replacement for information or advice that you receive from your in-person medical or therapy professionals. If you haven't already, I hope you'll consider subscribing, and for an even more personalized experience, please ask us about our memberships. Now, without further ado, let's start the show. All right, so what's the down and dirty on protein and levodopa absorption? The bottom line is, when we eat protein, those are large molecules that the body needs to break down in order to absorb them through the lining of the intestine into the bloodstream. Protein tends to break down into its elemental or basic amino acids in the gut, in the digestive enzymes, and then those amino acid complex molecules are in turn crossing the barrier between the intestine and the bloodstream. Levodopa has a similar size and structure to amino acids and tends to compete with absorption in the gut. So when you eat protein-heavy meals during or close to the time you take your medication, you're most likely going to have less levodopa in the bloodstream, and hence your overall dose will be less in the entire system. In addition, amino acids tend to compete at the blood-brain barrier when they cross into the brain, and you obviously need more levodopa in the brain than you do anywhere else. So it can be a problem at both ends. Now, this is in no way to advocate cutting protein out of your diet or eliminating protein from your diet. In fact, physicians would advise against that. Consuming protein in your diet is really crucial for proper nutrition. We all need protein, fat, and carbohydrates in order to maintain our body's metabolism and natural processes. However, and as I mentioned earlier, I'm going to talk about a couple of potential diet options that could work for protein levels. But for the purposes of this part of the video, we're really just going to be talking about how you can mitigate the problem of protein interfering with levodopa absorption, and how you have some control over that in terms of the timing of when you take your medications and around the times that you eat. I'll be sure to put links in the description to articles where this information can be referenced. It was actually on the Davis K. Finney Foundation website where I saw the reference to the 1 hour prior or up to 2 hours post meal for taking levodopa. And that was Dr. Sherian Karnapuja, who practices here in Oklahoma City, in Oklahoma, USA. He's quite a well-known movement disorder specialist at this point in time. Something interesting that he also said is that if you haven't had a bowel movement, it's likely that you'll have less absorption of levodopa than you would if you've had a bowel movement. And as I hope you know by now, as a person with Parkinson's disease, and if you don't, I'm going to link a video above that discusses constipation. Constipation is a common non-motor symptom of Parkinson's disease. It's almost a mixed motor non-motor, since it involves movement of the gut muscles, but it's something out of our control, so it's technically non-motor. It's an autonomic nervous system issue. And so it can be tricky to have a bowel movement every day, and so you could potentially be having those issues with absorption because you're unable to poop. Okay, so as I mentioned before, I want to talk a little bit about potential dietetic approaches to potentially help with the risk of having too much protein around medication times. Before we do that, though, I wanted to really briefly take the opportunity to answer one of our members' questions, which came from Phil, and he asked, what are off times? I'm really glad Phil asked that question because it goes right into why we're even discussing protein and levodopa absorption at this point. Off times refers to the periods where, in a person with Parkinson's, you can have a wearing off of medication effectiveness, so that if essentially between doses of levodopa, you're experiencing more symptoms, whether it's movement or non-movement symptoms or both. And it can be experienced even before the next dose is due, or well before in some cases. So if you are happening to have too much protein, or you're taking your medications too close to meals, then in that case, you may experience off times since your peak dose is not gonna be as high as it should be. Hope that answers your question, Phil. Let's get on with the rest of the video. So one of the two dietary options for managing protein and levodopa absorption is a low protein intake diet. Now, there's a big disclaimer on this, and again, I'm not recommending this. Dr. K does not recommend reducing protein in persons with Parkinson's disease, and I happen to agree with that. We need protein for the building blocks of our body. Protein is what we build muscle with. Protein is what our cells are made of. Protein is, it affects everything. But with that being said, I want to explain what the low protein diet might look like in terms of how much protein to consume, or not to consume in this case. So with a low protein diet, we're looking at no more than 10 grams of protein in a single day. That is extremely low. So again, I don't recommend that. I don't think any physician would ever recommend that, unless there's a very specific reason. But that is the explanation of what a low protein diet would be in terms of how many grams of protein we're looking at in an entire day's diet. Now the other option, which is a little bit safer, at least it sounds safer to me, is a protein redistribution diet. This is not where you're cutting out protein completely from your diet, but you're merely shifting the times at which you're consuming a certain amount of protein. So for example, a lower amount of protein early in the day and then a heavier amount later in the day. So I'll explain a little bit more about that in a second. So essentially the redistribution is as simple as it sounds. Basically, in the earlier hours of the day, breakfast, lunch, you're gonna have a smaller amount of protein, let's say around 7 grams in some studies that they've quoted here, up to 160 grams later, let's say supper or in the evening. So you're really not cutting out protein, you're just shifting that protein consumption to latter parts of the day. Now, with either of these diet types, there's really limited information or studies on whether or not that really improved persons with Parkinson's experience of levodopa dosing and whether it was as effective as it could be. Bottom line is, as we talked about earlier, I think timing is really the best thing to worry about rather than how much protein you're consuming. And we've got a movement disorder specialist recommendation to back that up. All right, to do a really brief recap of what we've talked about today in this video, and I realize there's a lot of information to think about and to digest.
Pun intended.
We've talked about the fact that protein may interfere with levodopa absorption at the level of the gut and potentially even at the blood-brain barrier. In addition to that, we've discussed two different dietetic approaches to protein consumption, including low protein diet and protein redistribution diet, neither of which are necessarily recommended by physicians. And I'm not advocating either of those, but I do encourage you to seek out information from a physician as well as to find a dietitian to work with, particularly even better, somebody that specializes in working with neurodegenerative disorders such as Parkinson's, MS, etc. And finally, we talked about timing of meals and how that's important and how that really can play a key role in your experience of medication effectiveness and to avoid off times as much as possible. To recap that, the general recommendation is 30 minutes prior to eating, taking your medication, or 1 hour following a meal. And the conservative recommendation found on Davis K. Finney is to take your medication an hour prior to eating, up to 2 hours after eating. One quick note too about timing of meals is that when you take your medication with a meal, as opposed to waiting before or after the meal, is your stomach has to actually empty out and has to start digesting. Your intestines have to start digesting and breaking down that food. So you not only have the issue of potentially interference of the amino acids blocking levodopa from being absorbed, but you also have the issue of the stomach needing to empty, which can take up to an hour before your medications are even starting to absorb. So really taking your meds before eating is one of the best ways to ensure that that levodopa is going right into the intestines as soon as possible. Well, as always, I hope that this was a helpful video for you. I hope it wasn't too long. I'd love to hear your feedback in the comments below. Let me know what you think. Let me know what videos, what materials, what content you want to hear on this channel, because this is your channel and it's for you. I look forward to the next time that we can sit down together and talk about Parkinson's disease and all the things that are important for you to know in order to live your best life with Parkinson's. Until that next sit down happens, I hope you're well. Have a blessed day, and as always, be empowered.